Hey YouTube, welcome back to UniXTCG, and this is the first video in my new space. And I know it doesn't really look that different from you guys, maybe just the angle, but there's a lot going on here that wasn't going on in the previous place. There's wood floors in here and it's a little emptier right now, so I will have to go get those soundproofing panels and make sure that, you know, the echo is in here, so bear with me for the first couple of videos of the year. Speaking of which, it is 2023. Happy to walk into this new year with all of you guys. I'm very, very excited to see what content creation where it's gonna take me this year. And I'm thinking some really, really big things are coming for UniXTCG, so just look out. That being said, we are currently entering the day, right? As of today, we are sitting at 2,874 subscribers. That means we are about 125 subs away from being at the big 300. That's a huge milestone and accomplishment. I think everybody that's joined on the past month, and we're gonna keep it going. We're going up, 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 up. So yeah, if you like the content, think about hitting that subscribe button if you haven't already. Like the video and comment on it so it trends, and we'll get a forum going. And you can also join the Discord so we can talk there too. I've been very, very busy just moving and trying to get content out and trying to do all the normal holiday stuff, but soon I'll be right back to being able to respond to everything. So, with that being said, let's get into today's topic. And yeah. So, somebody gave me the idea of talking about when to go first or second. And I'm sorry, I wanted to give you direct credit, but I have just looked through 4 videos worth of comments and I could not find your comment. So it's a little late right now, it's like 3 a.m. where I am. So I'm just gonna get into it. But you know who you are. If you're watching this video, you're gonna know who's you. And thank you for the idea. I feel like going first or second in this game is still largely an opinion based. I don't think there is a right or wrong. So all I can do is let you know how I play it and why I play it this way. So, granted, when it comes to like going first or second, I think decks and matchups are of course all different. I don't think this is a game like Dragon Ball Super right now where Yu-Gi-Oh! Where going first is like the end all be all. I think there are different merits for going first and going second. So starting off with red, if I'm playing Zoro, there are a fair amount of games where I am going to go second. The only matchup where I will not go second in green, or playing red Zoro, is if I'm playing the mirror. Because if I'm playing the mirror, I want to establish Robin faster than they can establish Robin, and I want to control the board from there. It's going to be a massive uphill battle, and going first, you're going to be able to establish a Robin, and if they try to establish a Robin in response, you can jet pistol their Robin and just keep it moving. Against green, playing Zoro, I like to go second. Why? Because they're going to have to open a Bonnie or a Momo in order to have a turn one play. And green is a deck where no standalone card does a lot. You have to use cards in conjunction. So naturally, that deck with less cards in hand definitely works. Against purple, I feel like it's almost the same thing. The deck had no top five search. It's all draw. So the smaller the opening hand, the less likely of a chance they're seeing things like Onigashima or Queen on curve. And if they happen to see Onigashima and Queen in opening hand, there's nothing you know about it anyway. But if they don't see Onigashima or Queen in opening hand, they have one less card deeper in their deck if they're going first. And if you don't see Queen or Onigashima, it almost doesn't matter that you're on the play in a Kaido deck, you're still going to be taking the D. So you're actually just going to be in a very bad space. So when it comes to blue, that one, I also feel like it's the same. They're going to be a deck that really, really gets on you late game. They can put up a bunch of blockers, but they need to have cards in hand. Now granted, going first, not only are they on the play, but they get to turn on certain cards like Love Love Mellow and Boa faster. So that is something. But I think that in red, a deck that doesn't have any inherent plus ones, all your stuff is break even, your Nami's, your in 2 years, those are all just play a card, so you go minus one, search a card, you go plus one. So that's just a net zero. So I think in red, it's just very important. Not to mention that in Zoro, going second is not bad. Going second, you could play a Nami and a Nami. You could play a Nami and a rested Don Nami. You can play a two drop BB or a two drop Sal. So it's like your size. So you basically can draw an extra card for going second, play on curve a 4K beater, and that makes it so that your next turn can be swing with a 5K 2-drop, swing with Zoro for 6K, and if you want at that point to play a Robin or a Zoro, you can. So I think that that's actually very important. Other notable mentions, Law, yeah, you just go second. Them with less cards in their hand is even more detrimental because they only have 4 life. You just don't want them to be able to build a defense while you tear through them. Blurple Crocodile, that one is rough, but you don't want them to have as many cards in hand. I do like going, like with red, it's very rare. Unless it's the mirror, I like going second in red. Now, going into Green Kid, that's where things are a little different. In Green Kid, you do want to hit your, you want to hit your ramp. Like, you want to hit your curve pretty hard in certain matchups. So going against red, I do go second because, like I said, red doesn't really see additional cards. It only breaks even or draws off the top of the deck. So because of this, my approach to red is taking it very slow and not giving them any cards from life until I'm sitting behind the kid and blockers, or maybe 2 kids. Basically a board that I don't think they can burst through easily. When that's the case, I start giving them cards 1, maybe 2 at a time from their life, and I close it out. So going and making them go first forces them to have an in 2 years or a Nami, or their first turn play is just draw, or not even draw, just open up, dawn, pass. And I like that. I like them having as little cards in hand as possible. Green versus green, I will always go first because I want to establish a Kiku. That's just a thing. Green versus purple, I will have them go first. I know lots of people are like, well, Kaido on the curve, but like I said, if Kaido doesn't see Onigashima or Queen, I don't want them to have any extra cards that may dig them out of that bad hand, and I am willing to go second because, in all honesty, going second should allow me to establish maybe a bonding to Momo, a bonding to blocker, and they still have another turn before they can play a king or anything to wipe anything off. So that's how I feel about that. Against blue, it's a little rough because if it's Dofi, I do want to establish my 8-drop kit as soon as possible, but the fact of the matter for me is that searching top 5 over and over and over again and having what I think should be a good ratio of 3 Dofis, 3 Mihawks, they should find a Dofi and a Mihawk before you play Kid. Kid is a 10 Dawn play regardless because you need to pay 8 for it, put a Dawn under it, and you likely would like to have a Dawn open for something like Paradise Waterfall. So with that being said, I do think that Kid is a 10 drop play in most cases, and that's just, that gives them enough time to just play a preemptive Mihawk or a preemptive Dofi to make sure that you cannot have just an uncontested kit. That's what I've been finding in my experience. So with them going first, yeah, you're going to be on the curve, but things like Bonnie don't really stick. They can always bounce Bonnie. There's a lot of things. They can bounce your blocker and swing on Bonnie. So Bonnie doesn't necessarily stick the way you think it would. And on top of that, I mean, if you're going, you're going 1, then it's there 2, then you know you're at 3, then it's there 4. So regardless of whether you go first or second, they still will be able to hit Dofi and Mihawk before you can hit your kid efficiently. So I generally would go second so they have one less card in hand. I like going second a lot, I'm not gonna lie. When it comes to Kaido, this is where it starts switching up. In Kaido, I like to go first against the mirror because regardless, you want to outcurve the mirror. Everything the mirror is doing, you want to be better. I think that's like a theme here for most cases. I've been going first in the mirror, but Kaido wants to go first in the mirror. I think Kaido also wants to go second against red because red has one less card to beat your face in with. Yes, they can play a Nami or in 2 years, but what they can't do is play a 2-drop and then come at you twice the next turn. Yeah, I think what I like doing is having red go first just so it has one less card in hand because I am in control matchup and I don't want them having any more resources. Against green, it's a little rough. I think against green, I do go first. We need to play Onigashima on curve and we need to have that access to 7-drop kid or king as soon as possible. It's just the fact of the matter is when you're playing against kid as purple deck, you need to make sure that you keep your life as high as possible because the moment your life drops to 2, maybe 1, you cannot play the 10 drop without fear of dying the next turn. So you need to make sure that you set up. So personally, I like playing kid, or I like playing Kaido, you know, just up at, I like going first against green. Against blue, it's the same thing. you want to be able to hit Onigashima on play, like on the curve, and you want to make sure that you are constantly wiping their board, killing their boas, killing their small blockers, that you can make sure that your meaningful damage puts them on a clock like it does every other deck. Personally, with Dofi, I have liked going second a lot. The main reason why I like going second is because my first turn can be Perona and Law. And if I have the broken opening of Perona and Law, that means my next turn, I can now use Dofi's effect. Dofi's effect can put something into play, rest it, and that Law will protect it, and I have Spada available. Those are my favorite setups for Dofi. Being able to Perona Law, play into a Warlord, have Spada ready. Now, the other thing you can do is also play Perona, and then you use Dofi's effect as 3 Dawn, and then you tap one for the Law in your hand if you have it. Either way, going second almost wholeheartedly assures that what I play off of Dofi is going to survive until the next turn. And that's where the momentum comes in. You play so often off the top of your deck, you don't have to use your hand until it really matters. And that's where Dofi's strength lies in. So against red, yeah, I'm trying to go second. Against blue, yeah, I'm trying to go second. I want to see more cards. I want them to see less cards. And no matter going first or second, I'm going to be able to establish a Dofi or a Mihawk before they can establish an 8-drop kid. Against Kaido, that is the one where I would heavily think about going first, mainly because you just don't want them being able to play like on curve and doing Kaido things. But then again, once again, you're going to be able to hit those Dofis. You won't be able to hit, if they get Onigashima and they get their ramp off from other cards, you won't be able to hit your Dofis and your Mihawks before they hit their big boys, so you're kind of putting each other on a block. It is really weird. I did beat a Kaido. I lost to a Kaido, and I beat 2 Kaidos last locals. I don't know why I face Kaido so much with blue. But it really is a momentum race. You really are just swinging at them, and it feels a lot like green. If you can get them down low enough and Dofi is an aggressive blue deck, then you don't have to fear the 10 drop because they have to fear dying the next turn. If they 10 drop and you have like 3 life and they have like 1, you follow it up with a return Mihawk and pass, like swing, return Mihawk, swing the chip of damage and pass, it's just rough for them. Like they're going to be in another position where they're like, crap, I'm on the clock too, except he has more life. So there you kind of go. That is my assessment of those. Like I said, every deck is a little different. I want to know in the comments how you feel. I'm going to put chapters so you guys can skip around to see which decks I was talking about. And let me know what you feel is appropriate for each deck. Let me know if you agree, disagree. But I feel like whether you go first or second, you need to acknowledge what your deck is trying to do, what your opponent's deck is trying to do, and figure out which is more advantageous for them. That extra card, that being on the curve, and you need to decide accordingly. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys liked the video. This one is less of a factual one, more of a discussion. I'd love to see your thoughts in the comments. And yeah, cheers to the first video of the new year. I will see you guys later. We're coming out with Zenkai 03 spoilers for Dragon Ball Super, so I'll be covering those throughout the week. We'll be covering more stuff for One Piece. I'm gonna see if I can get some locals games up on here. So thanks. You guys have a great day. Let's see if we can make that big 3,000. We are 125 subscribers away right now. See you guys.